Welcome back to Living 808. It's time now for some 808 style. All right, well, it's time for 808 style, you guys. We are talking today about a growing trend in tattoos, and Marko Livingston is the owner of Street Felt Hawaii and joins us with more. Aloha, Marko.
Thank you for having me.
Of course, so happy to have you. Now, this is really neat because I feel like, you know, when we do our 808 style, we talk about trends, but tattoos, I mean, I feel like they've been trendy for a long time. I mean, it's something that's so iconic and really not going away. So let's talk about just, well, first off, let's talk about what you do in general. Talk about Street Felt Hawaii.
Street Felt Hawaii is a tattoo slash art supply graffiti shop that I opened about 8 years ago. Opening the shop, I came up with the name Street Felt, which is kind of relates to heartfelt, love for the street, where graffiti kind of comes from, and I believe tattoo kind of stems from as well. So combine the two, we got Street Felt Tattoo, and that's where I've been for about 8 years, yeah.
And look at that, so all of these, I'm assuming, are your work,
yes,
right?
Yeah.
Wow. Oh, I love that, vandalized. Now, let's talk about some of the other types of art you do, because you do the street art, but I mean, a lot of this is so gorgeous.
Yeah, street art, murals for different local businesses or festivals and events. I've done a bunch of that, and I really enjoy doing that as well.
Okay, so it's not just art on the body. You do it all over the place.
Yeah, correct.
Awesome. Okay, so for like some of the ones that you've done around town, where are you?
Let's see. I've got some in Chinatown, some restaurants in Kaka'ako. So Earl is restaurant or a sandwich spot.
Uh-huh.
Started his before he had opened the Kaka'ako location. Also
yes.
Pitch in the Salt.
Yes. Oh my gosh. Okay, I've definitely seen your work.
Yeah.
That's awesome. You're so talented.
Thank you.
But let's talk about tattoos though. Where did that interest start?
Oh man, I don't know how it really started. I was really into cars and lowriders, and you know, I would see tattoos. I came from Southern California and moved to Hawaii in 1993 when I was 13. So kind of brought that whole look over and, you know, hand poked tattoos on myself. In eighth grade, and you know, figured out how to make, you know, tattoo machines in high school, and then it wasn't until 2007 where I was like, I'm really gonna do this.
Wow, yeah. That's awesome. And then what about the inspiration behind your art?
I'm inspired by, I guess, where things come from. So if it's a traditional tattoo, I'm gonna look back to, you know, the old Sailor Jerry stuff. Mm-hmm. If it's traditional Japanese tattooing, I'm gonna date back to Horiyoshi and beyond, and really just, I study the craft before I do the art and make sure I'm doing the right, you know, the right things for the right people. Yeah,
I'm not gonna do a
Hawaiian tattoo on like a Samoan person unless they want, you know, specific patterns and things for different cultures.
Okay, yeah. Oh, I love that. And it seems like, I mean, granted, obviously, I'm sure you can do all the different styles, but I love that a lot of your stuff is really colorful.
Oh, thank you, yeah.
It's really pretty. Nice, okay, so that's your inspiration of your tattoos, but what about behind your graffiti art?
Behind the graffiti art, I kind of, you know, same thing from California. I would see gang graffiti around town in school, and, you know, I just had a name and wrote it for whatever reason it was. And at one point in life, I decided I'm just going to give up on art and
really?
Just work. And at that point, I came across some friends that actually did graffiti, and I was like, oh, spray paint, this is what they use. And okay, this is going to be fun. So I just full on went with it.
Oh, that's amazing. And then look at where you are right now.
Yeah. You know,
that's incredible.
Two things like your parents probably don't want your kid to do tattoos and graffiti, but they were, I love them, man. They're so supportive. And I wouldn't be here today if it wasn't for that support.
That's incredible. And I feel like as a creative too, you know, you don't want to stifle that. You know, I can't imagine like someone that can do such incredible work and doing the traditional job, right? So it's awesome that you're able to do this. So cool. Okay, so if anyone wants to find out about your work, maybe get you to do a mural or add some art to their body, where can we find you?
Yeah, my Instagram is Marko Tattoos, MarkoTattoos. Also, the Instagram for the tattoo shop is Street Felt Hawaii, StreetFelt Hawaii. Website, phone number, it's all there.
Wonderful. And in terms of trends, what are kind of like the main, or maybe not even trends, what's popular right now? What do you see a lot of people coming in for?
Either like a lot of big work, full body work, sleeves, those are always still popular. And then like a lot of like real fine line detailed stuff. So single needle work where you're just using one needle to create pieces of intricacy or delicacy.
That's wonderful. Yeah. It's such a skill, and I was talking to you off camera a little earlier. I am just not artistic in any way, so I'm always so impressed when I can see the art that you're able to create. So awesome, and again, if you want to get in touch with him, we'll have all of his info on our website at k20.com. Thanks so much.
Thank you.
All right, Mikey, over to you.
Thanks, guys. All right, now if you're gonna check out Marko's work around town, make sure you use Neutrogena. Now this week's Neutrogena feature product is the Rapid Wrinkle Repair Daily Face Moisturizer with SPF 30 and hyaluronic acid. Now this moisturizer helps to visibly fade stubborn wrinkles, including crow's feet, forehead, and chink wrinkles. This top-selling moisturizer helps moisturize, also known as diminish the age of the age spots. Now this supercharged formula is combined with UVA and UVB SPF 30 to help visibly younger looking skin in just 1 week. Log on to k22.com for more information.